Valley Beautiful people, welcome back to the channel. I'm here at eevee's picking up my Gold S22 Pro. A lot of you have asked, you know, after all the several wheels I've owned in the last year and what my favorites are, you all know. I love the M10-4 a lot. I've had the S18, the T4, I've ridden the V11, the V12, I had the Master, I've had a Sherman, I've had the S22 regular. A lot of people are pushing me to get the EX30 or the Master Pro, and I am personally not interested in either one of those wheels. However, the one wheel missing from the rack that you guys may have noticed is the Patton. Patton, as they call it here. This wheel is absolutely amazing. I am in love with it. A lot of you guys asked if I would get one, and I wasn't really wanting one after the T4, so I didn't want a 16-inch wheel. However, I rode that around, and it is absolutely amazing, guys. They also have lots of the TSG passes, if you guys are interested in those. They are one of the few places that have all of them in all of the colors. So shout out to them for having those. Shout out to them for having the limited edition S22s and 16Xs, because I don't know if you guys saw my post, but Alien Rides, E-Wheels, UCO, Rev Rides, they wouldn't get them. Alien Rides refused to. I think E-Wheels is ordering them, but I didn't want their 40T packs. But back to this beast. As you guys know, I'm getting the Commander Pro Mini, and there isn't a lot about the suspension on it. This wheel basically has the same suspension as its larger counterpart, the Sherman S, which now I'm very tempted to get one while I'm here. But wow, like holy crap. The T4s were great wheels. However, when you compare it side by side with an 18-inch, like I did on my off-roading review with the T4 V1, V2 with the V3 board, and the S22, there was no comparison. They don't absorb as well, smaller stuff. You know, you could just feel it when it impacts the tire, even at higher tire pressures. They just don't absorb as nicely. And this wheel is the cushiest thing I have ever ridden. It is absolutely amazing. And Bradley was worried about me getting on it or buying one of the 62-pound rating because I'm 220 pounds, and it's not rated for that. You know, I'm not a hardcore rider, as a lot of you know, but I really like my soft, cushiony wheels. My Hero's got a 650-pound coil on it, which is super easy to bottom out. So for this, having the 62-pound, I rode it around. I tried to get you guys some video, but with my phone, there's too much wind out there, and the vocals weren't coming through, and I don't have a mic with me. I really had to bounce to get it to bottom out. Going off curbs, a bliss. Going up things, hitting rocks, you know, just that when the sidewalk, when you have those separated concrete blocks and they kind of raise up from each other and you hit those, and, you know, some wheels you hit them, you go, oh God, there goes a rim, and some wheels you hit them, you just go right over them. That, for a 16-inch wheel, goes right over that stuff. And again, it's probably tuned to Bradley's weight, which is 150 pounds or so. I don't know. He's a smaller guy. So at 220 pounds, if it was properly tuned, that 62 pounds would probably be sufficient for a lot of people that aren't into doing, you know, stair drops or giant jumps or, you know, BMX tracks or something. If you're a casual cruising street rider, 62 pounds is a bliss. I did check, though, for the Sherman S on what rating that one is, and it is a 62 pound. So I was contemplating buying it. There you go. But hopping on it, you know, the wheel's got quite a bit more weight to it than the Patton or the Patton. So it did feel too soft. There was too much take up and it didn't pop right back up, but it isn't tuned properly. So if it was tuned like the Patton, you know, your adjustments here on either side, it could be better, but again, I don't know if it would be, and I don't want to mess with their floor model. I gotta check with David if he'll let me, but for the Patton, the 62 pound is perfect for my weight, like absolutely amazing, and I bet it could be tuned even better. So just quick shout out, you know, quick view of the store and everything here. There, I got cut off there. No big problem, but you know, I think they moved their service center, so they don't do it out here anymore. But they do sell all the scooters and all of the wheels here. And you know, Bradley and Luke are amazing. David, I met him today. He's absolutely amazing. Everybody here's so nice and friendly and helpful. And they're working on a new site, so hopefully it'll be, you know, a better site. There's a lot of info out there. A lot of people get overwhelmed with wheels and what they should get, and you know, so many wheels say they can't, their max rating is what people's weight is. And I always try to push that, you know, even at 220 pounds, that the M10-4, this little guy, I could ride it around at 25 miles an hour with no problem. So for those guys that are heavier, you know, I'm not saying go get an M10-4, but I'm just saying, you know, specs wise, don't always rely on what the manufacturers put. So again, this is a perfect example. Is at 62 pounds for that coil system, shock system. It's not rated for somebody my weight. However, I felt it was absolutely amazing. So just as a heads up, you know, I always try to give you guys my honest feedback of wheels and all the above. Ooh, it looks like they have electronic skateboards too. Look at this. Look at this. Cool, they've got it all. I've tried to go to Rev Rides a couple of times and either I call and can't get through to those people, or the one time I tried to go in there two times, it was like by appointment only or something, so I haven't actually visited those guys, even though they're way closer to me. Yeah, I just wanted to give everybody an overview. I have an S19 that'll ship eventually, the Commander Pro Mini, if it doesn't perform anything like the Patton there. I'm going to be extremely disappointed in that wheel. It's higher voltage, it should have a more powerful motor. It has slightly larger batteries, 22 versus 24 100 watt hours, so it's heavier, but performance-wise it should be better. However, with comparing wheels all the time, you find out real quick that just because it has higher specs doesn't mean it technically performs better. So I was always a big fan of my S18s, I sold them both recently, these little guys here. And in conjunction, like if you ride the S18, it is very peppy, it's very smooth, it's very quick. There's not a lot of grunting or hesitation. You hop on the Hero, you hop on an RS19, you hop on a T4, there's a lot of that. So, you know, tuning is everything, and the firmware plays a big role too. So, considering the Patton is LeaperKim and the Commander Pro Mini is going to be Bagode, I have a feeling that even with that extra power, it's not gonna be as smooth and as nice of a ride as the Patton, which is gonna make me sad. But I can't say that yet, so I might end up getting one of these lovelies. Hopefully I'm getting all that on video. I never use my phone, it's a horrible phone. But as I get these wheels, I'm going to review them. If I need to repair anything, take anything apart, modify anything, you guys know that I'll do that. So just keep an eye on the channel. The gold is probably going to be posted tomorrow for my overview on it. I did open a couple of them here, so I have some feedback on them. But I may end up getting the Patton. So you guys will see, you know. Hope that you guys enjoy the video and enjoy my little tour here at Eevee's. Say hi to everybody, give them a big shout out. They've got wheels in stock, they got helmets in stock. Give them some orders, guys, give them some orders. So appreciate the follows, the subscribes, the comments. If you guys have any questions, drop it down below. I'm always on it to answer, and stay beautiful.